The next
Yeah.
one we're going to be talking about is the Quick Lane Bowl. We've got New Mexico State and Bowling Green, both teams 6-6. Bowling Green apparently favorites to win at one minus 165 on the money line. Only expected to win by 3.5 points, and the over-under is 48 points. One of those games where I haven't watched either team play.
What's
So
your
it's
gut
just,
say?
I mean, you know, my gut goes with New Mexico State just because I like the program in general that they have over there and how usually decent they are in their respective conference. But yeah, I guess New Mexico State for the win. I haven't watched either of these teams play a single minute of football this year, so now is my
Yeah.
chance to do that. So what about you? I mean, again, maybe you've seen a Bowling Green or New Mexico State game.
Bowling Green played UCLA and they looked very, very average and they did not look good at
Oh, that
all.
was your first game of the season, right?
Yeah, like we just trounced them. So I don't think, I mean, the thing is, it's not really a fair comparison, but I don't know. I'm gonna take Bowling Green. I don't know why not. -3.5. I might have New Mexico State cover, but I'm gonna take Bowling Green to win outright and then under 48.
So you think it'll be like a one
A
point,
close
two
game.
point
A
game?
close
Yeah.
game. Two
Okay.
point, yeah. Close game.
Yeah, I mean, you know, I understand. If you actually watch them play, then might as well root for
I
them.
have no idea,
I
honestly.
just like the program they got at New Mexico State, I'll be honest. So, you know, that's kind of, I feel like one of those moms when like you ask her, oh, who do you think's gonna win this game? You're like, oh, I think this team's gonna win because I like the colors of their jerseys. And it's like, okay, bro. The next game, again, Camellia Bowl. We've got Georgia Southern against Buffalo. Both teams are 6-6. Georgia Southern favorites, I guess, minus 170 on the money line. Only expected to win by 3.5. Over under is 66.5. That is a big over under.
That's a big number, yeah.
I want you to tell me what you think about that, and I'm gonna figure out why it's such a big over under for that game.
I'm gonna take Georgia Southern just because it's in Alabama and it's a lot closer for Georgia Southern. It's gonna be a home game for them, and
Yeah.
I just think they might have like a. I mean, Buffalo probably has a pretty physical defense, so I feel like they might just like be. I feel like Georgia Southern is gonna win that game, covering 3.5. Yeah, why not? They'll cover the 3.5, and then over under 67. I don't know why it's that high. I'm definitely gonna take the under on that one, but yeah, I mean that seems a little excessive.
I mean, now that I'm looking at it, both teams probably averaged somewhere around 35 and 40 points. So I think that's why the over under is so high. The only time that there were two instances where Buffalo scored less than 30 points, and that was in their win against Miami, Ohio, when they beat them 24 to 20. And in their win against Akron when they beat them 23 to 22. Or actually, no, they actually scored less than 30 against Ohio, against Central Michigan, and Kent State, and Coastal Carolina, and Maryland. Jesus Christ, I'm not reading these correctly. Yeah, Maryland, that first game, they only scored 10 points. But ever since, they've scored at least 20 points in all of their games. And kind of the same story for Georgia Southern here. Georgia Southern, Morgan State, they beat them 59-7, beat Nebraska 45-42, lost to UAB 35-21, beat Ball State, Coastal Carolina, Georgia State, James Madison, Old Dominion. Yeah, they scored 10 points again, their lowest amount against Marshall, second to last game in the season. But they did beat App State, who, you know, App State made a name of themselves this year, and they beat them
Yeah.
51-48. So I don't know. I would just go for Georgia Southern just because they're the favorites, and I feel like they play in the stronger conference. I feel like the Sun Belt is a little more competitive. But yeah, got them on the money line. The spread, don't know enough about either two teams. So spread, you know, who knows? Maybe Buffalo keeps it within one score. And then, yeah, the over under, I would definitely go over. I can kind of see why they would go 66. It is high, but again, these are teams that score a lot of points. So six, six and
Fair.
a half makes sense. We're going to move on quickly to the Serve Pro First Responders Bowl. We've got Memphis against Utah State. Both teams are 6-6. Memphis coming in as the heavy favorites, -295 on the money line, only expected to win by no more than 8 points, and the over under 61.5. What have you got for me, Memphis or Utah State?
I'm just going to do a quick pick on this one. I just think Memphis is going to win. I think it's going to go over 61.5, and I think that Memphis is going to cover.
Yeah, for me, I think Memphis have been pretty disappointing this year, and I think they're going to continue that trend. I'm going to have Utah State being the heavy underdogs. I still got them winning the game. The spread, I do think it'll be close, so I do think Utah State will cover that spread. And then the over-under, again, 61.5 is very high scoring. Haven't looked at any of the games, but usually when you've got two teams that are from different pretty decent conferences, they tend to score a lot of points. So I'll go over on the over-under on that. The next game is the Ticket Smarter Birmingham Bowl. We've got East Carolina and Coastal Carolina. Coastal Carolina are 9-3. East Carolina are 7-5. We've got East Carolina coming in as the favorites, -325 on the money line. They're not expected to win by more than 8 points. And the over-under is 62 points. Going into this, remember in the middle of the season, I had a pick against UCF and East Carolina, and that was the difference between me getting paid and me not getting paid. And so from that moment onwards, I've always decided just to hate East Carolina for no reason whatsoever because they were the difference in me getting paid. So I'm just going to go with Coastal Carolina. They've got the better record for a reason. Coastal Carolina have made a name for themselves in recent years. I feel like it'll be a close game just because I know East Carolina is good. 62 is a bit high for these two teams, so I would have that as the under 62 points. For you, good sir, what have you got?
This is a tough game because Coastal Carolina has been good in recent years, but Eastern Carolina had like a decent year, 7-5, not terrible, but they've played some close games against good teams like Tulane, and I mean, they lost 24-9, but it wasn't terrible. And then they had a close game against Cincinnati, but they got absolutely housed by Houston. So I'm going to actually go with Coastal Carolina in this game. I think they're going to win, cover, and I think it's going to go over 62.
Okay. The next one is the Guaranteed Rate Bowl. We have the 6-6 Wisconsin Badgers against the 7-5 Oklahoma State Cowboys. Oklahoma State, surprisingly underdogs in this game, I would say. They definitely have been disappointing this season, but you look at a team like Wisconsin and what they've done in the Big Ten, and I don't know. I feel like they're just as or even more so disappointing than Oklahoma State has been this year, but 3 points is the spread. It's supposed to be a very close game, and it's supposed to be low scoring as well, over under at 43 points. Me personally, I have Oklahoma State winning that game. I really thought this would be a closer matchup. I definitely didn't think that Oklahoma State would be in the positive side of the money line. But, you know, if they are, another good sign for bettors, get the money up. So, yeah, I would go Oklahoma State. The spread, I do believe that these teams are somewhat evenly matched. So I would pick Oklahoma State to cover that spread. And then the over-under, 43. Yes, Wisconsin definitely haven't had a lot of high-scoring games. Oklahoma State have, on the other hand. So it really is 50-50. I'll just go with the over just because I think Oklahoma State can score 30 points against Wisconsin. But, yeah, what do you think?
Yeah, I think – so both of their quarterbacks are transferring. So I think that's going to be a big issue for both of their offenses. Mm-hmm. I'm going to take the under 43 because of that. Again, I don't really see a reason why Wisconsin is favored because the Big Ten West is a terrible conference.
Exactly.
And I don't really understand that, but I'm definitely going to take Oklahoma State to cover and win outright and then the under because of the quarterbacks.
Yep, makes absolute sense. Next game is the Military Bowl presented by Parathon. We've got UCF, which stands for University of Central Florida, for those of you who do not know. And we have the Duke Blue Devils. UCF are 9-4. Duke are 8-4. Duke come in as the favorites, expected to win by 3 points. And the over-under at a high 62.5. Your thoughts? What do you think is going to be happening in that game?
I think UCF has they have coach Gus Malzahn from Auburn. He's a good coach. Their team has had a good year. 9-4 is a pretty good year. They've had that undefeated season a few years ago. They're one of the better non-Power Five programs in college football. Duke, on the other hand, is in the ACC, terrible conference. UCLA does actually have the transfer Jake Bobo from Duke and a few transfers from Duke, but I think that UCF is going to win this game. I'm going to take them to cover because they're dogs, but I'm going to take UCF to win, to cover, and then 62.5 is a lot. I need to see their offenses. I mean, I feel like that might be a little much, but I'm going to take the under. I'm going to take the under.
Yeah, for me, like you said, Coach Gus, one of the greatest to do it. So I do, I will have UCF winning this game. Spread close game against Duke, I can see that. The 62.5, I do understand because I do recall that Duke was a very high scoring team this year.
Yes.
Their off
Yeah.
their
Yeah.
offense is really good. Excuse me. Their offense is really good, but their defense does lack, which is the reason why they lost so many games but scored so many points. So I would go with the over for 62.5. I feel like Duke, we might see Duke score, 40 points this game, and then UCF just kind of go back and forth with them, also causing them to score 40 points. But yeah, I would go UCF winning, UCF covering the spread just because it'll probably be like a 1 point, 2 point game, and then the over as well on 62.5. The next one is going to be the AutoZone Liberty Bowl. We have the 6-6 Kansas Jayhawks against the 6-6 Arkansas Razorbacks. Your thoughts off the bat? We have Razorbacks, the favorites at -150 on the money line, expected to win by a field goal, and the over-under is at 69 points. What have you got for that?
I'm just going to do a quick pick on this one. I'm going to take Arkansas to win. Kansas has really struggled at the end of the year, especially with their quarterback getting hurt. I'm going to take Arkansas to win. Definitely the under on that game. I feel like Arkansas's defense is going to step up because it's at 69. I think it's going to hit the under. And then Arkansas is going to cover -3.
I'll do a quick pick as well. I like the way Kansas played football this year, despite losing their quarterback, like you say. It's definitely been a whole different energy over there. Definitely trying to get fans more involved, and I feel like this is the perfect way to try and get them more involved for next season. Maybe watch the game, even go to the game, support your team, support your college. I'd like to see the Jayhawks win, rock chalk all the way. The spread, I don't know. I feel like Arkansas have been a really big letdown, so much of a letdown that I think
True.
that Kansas will beat them by more than 3 points. So yeah, and then the over under a little bit too high for me. So I'm gonna go under on that. Now, a big one for me especially, but for the channel as a whole, this is an Oregon UCLA channel at the end of the day. We've got the San Diego County Credit Union Holiday Bowl. Wow, that is a mouthful. We've got the 9-4 North Carolina Tar Heels, the 9-3 15th ranked Oregon Ducks. Oregon, the heaviest favorites in the bowl game this year. They are the biggest favorites throughout all the bowl games. They're at -560 on the money line, expected to win by 14 points, and the over-under is at 72. As an Oregon fan, I feel like I should go first. God, I love my team. I don't like how we finished against Oregon State. I'll be honest, that was brutal. We should have played USC in the Pac-12 championship and lost that game. Not only that, North Carolina are a horrible team. I watched North Carolina play against Clemson's backup quarterback while I was in Vegas watching the Pac-12 championship, and they were awful. So, yeah, I feel like no matter how much film North Carolina watches, no matter how many practices, how many reps they do, they are still not a better team on this planet against any other team. Oregon, that -560 just really hammers it home. Not only that, but they're projected to win by 14 points. And on top of that, it's supposed to be a 72-point game. Now, I could see this going to 80 points. Oregon, 40
Yeah,
points across the
yeah.
board in all of their wins. They scored 40 points except for their game against Utah, where they only scored 20. Again, Oregon, Definitely the money line. I can see them beating North Carolina by like three touchdowns easily. And over under, I can see Oregon scoring 50 points. I know this is very biased coming from an Oregon fan, but I just think that it is so disrespectful for us to be matched up against a team like North Carolina. I just don't see how that was made possible. I need to know the guy who is in charge of this San Diego Holiday Bowl because he's clearly off his goddamn rocker. But yeah, Oregon, easy dub. I don't know about you. What do you think?
I totally agree. Oregon was a very good team this year. They lost to Georgia, which kind of screwed up the whole like set season for them because it created this whole narrative that the Pac-12 wasn't good and they couldn't compete. And then they had the tough loss late in the year to Washington, which they should have won that game. They just mismanaged the clock. And then they lost to Oregon State and they should have won that. So I feel like Oregon this year could have easily been a 11-1 or 12-1 team making it to the college football playoff. That team has crazy talent and their offensive line is amazing. Their quarterback's amazing. They have one of the best offenses in the country. Oregon is going to win this game big. I think that North Carolina and the ACC are a terrible conference. And I feel like I totally agree. I don't understand why Oregon is playing North Carolina in a bowl game. Same thing with Oregon State playing Florida. I don't know why they're having these Pac-12s, all these ranked Pac-12 schools play unranked ACC schools. I don't get that, but it is what it is.
Unranked and barely above 500
schools. Yeah.
Because that's what they think the Pac-12 is. It's brutal it's totally how they think that. Oh, the Pac-12 is so bad. They've had the most amount of ranked teams this year.
The Pac-12 is the second best. The Pac-12 is the second best conference in college football this year, behind the SEC. The Big Ten has three good teams, but besides that, the Big Ten is terrible.
We saw Purdue face Michigan in the championship. Exactly.
So sticking with that narrative, I think Oregon is going to win this game big. I can see them scoring 45 points easily.
Yep.
With that being said, North Carolina had a good quarterback in Drake May, so they might put up some points, which is why I'm a little worried about the minus 14 and the 72-point over-under, because I feel like Oregon will get out to a big lead and then kind of let them back in at the end of the game, but still win the game comfortably. So I feel like I still think that Oregon's going to win by more than 14, so I'm going to take Oregon minus 14. But I'm going to take the under 72. I think it's going to be like a 45 to like 20, 27, 45, 20. That's right at 72.
That's 72.
Right at 72. But I think that's like the max. I just don't think that – think it's a little sketchy.
I can see that. All right. So got to calm it down because people that are watching right now, you have no, because we were in the same, we were hanging out when we went to the UCLA Oregon basketball game when the bowl game came out. You remember how pissed I was that we got North Carolina as a bowl. So disrespectful for what we've accomplished this year. Yeah. That is so disrespectful. And I feel like people are still focused on that 49-3 loss against Georgia, and people just need gotta get over it.
They gotta get over it.
Moving on, let's do some quick picks here just because a lot of these teams are just like meh. Texas Bowl, Texas Tech 7-5, Ole Miss 8-4. Who you got?
Ole Miss is gonna win this game. The Big 12 is kind of weak, so I'm gonna take Ole Miss to win this game, cover, and definitely the under.
Yeah, again, I've got Ole Miss same as you. Texas Tech, really haven't seen anything from them. They've played in a pretty decent conference in the Big 12, but the Big 12 has really been owned by teams like TCU and Kansas State. And they've just been shut out by those teams. So, yeah, I got Ole Miss, Lane Kiffin for that win. The next is the Bad Boy Mowers Pinstripe Bowl. We've got 7-5 Syracuse against 8-5 Minnesota. Syracuse, Minnesota, who'd you have for that win? Syracuse are coming in as a heavy underdog, though.
Yeah, I just think that Minnesota is going to win this game because they have a good run game and a good defense. I'm going to take Minnesota to win the game. I think it's going to hit the under, actually. Under 42, which is surprising. I'm going to take the under, and I'm going to take it's a little sketch because -7.5 and being under 42, it's not that many points, but I'm going to take Syracuse to cover. So I think it's going to be a close game. Under 42, and Minnesota's going to win.
I'm actually going to have Syracuse winning that game. Not because I've seen Syracuse play, but I've seen Minnesota play, and I've seen Minnesota play in the Big Ten, which is probably one of the
They're both very average teams. Yeah.
Yeah. So, Minnesota, I haven't seen anything too crazy from them. I've seen them get blown out at home this year and blown out on the road. So yeah, Syracuse, they've always kind of remained in the rankings this entire year. They just dropped out recently, whereas Minnesota have kind of been, they get in, they lose, and then they get out, whereas Syracuse, they'll win a few games, stay in. So I've got Syracuse. As for the over-under, again, don't know too much about either team. 42.5 does seem a bit low, so I would just go with the over. And like you said, I feel like it could be a close game. So definitely keeping it within 7.5 points is something I would pick. Next is the Cheez-It Bowl, everyone's favorite. We have the Oklahoma Sooners against the 13th ranked Florida State Seminoles. Sooners being 6-6, Florida State being 9-3, of course. 9-3 being heavy favorites at -315 on the money line. Expected to win by no more than 8 points. And the over-under is at 65.5 points. I'm just going to say it. Don't be fooled by Florida State and their program and the fact that they're 9-3. They still play in the ACC, and they are still a horrible team, despite the fact that they're 13th ranked.
They are way overranked. They are way overranked. They should be 20th at the highest.
But the thing is that Oklahoma is even more of a worse team than Florida
worse.
State
they're
is.
Even worse, though. Yeah.
So this is literally going to be the battle of absolute garbage. Giving them a 65.5 over under is such a generous thing to do, because neither team is going to cross 20 points. I'm taking Florida State to win the game. It'll be close. It'll be like 20-17, something stupid like that. But yeah, what do you think on that game?
Okay, so I think that Florida State's going to win. I think both teams are very average, not that good. I don't understand why Florida State's not playing a team like Oregon, UCLA, Oregon
State.
That's
what I'm saying.
Instead of Oklahoma, but that's fine. The College Football Playoff Committee wants to do what they want to do, so let them do what they want to do.
They're on something. They've definitely been
on
something.
I don't think they watch the games, honestly. They don't really.
Yeah, I think they just go, well, I like that team and
I like
that
team against that team. Yeah, no, they're terrible. But I'm going to take Florida State to win. I'm actually going to take the over in this game, which is surprising because it's very high, 65.5. I'm going to take the over. And I think that Oklahoma is actually going to cover. I'm going to say Oklahoma's going to cover. So I'm going to say Florida State to win, Oklahoma to cover, and over 65.5.
Okay.
Now we've got a big game. This is a big game.
Yeah, so the one he's talking about is the Valero Alamo Bowl. It's between the 20th ranked Texas Longhorns and the 12th ranked Washington Huskies. Now, Texas are 8-4 and have had a tough time in the Big 12. The Washington Huskies are 10-2. They, on the other hand, haven't really had that much of a tough time in the Pac-12. They unfortunately got unlucky not making it to the Pac-12 championship against USC. But it is safe to say that Texas are the favorites, and favorites by more than what they should be, all because this is essentially a home game for them. To be
fair.
That
is true. That is true. Yeah.
So, Texas, if this was played anywhere else, I feel like you'd expect to see both teams in the negative for the money line, but we've got only Texas in the negative expected to win. They're not expected to win more than 5 points. And the over-under is at a ridiculous 68.5 points. I'm just going to say it. Washington beat Oregon. Washington can beat Texas.
I agree. I think that Texas being basically a home game is an advantage for them, but they have been so disappointing this year, and they almost remind me of the Dallas Cowboys in the sense that everyone, whenever they have high expectations, they always underperform. They almost beat Alabama at the beginning of the year. They lost that game. Then they lost a close game to TCU when everyone thought that they were going to beat TCU. And they just have had a ton of meltdowns this year. I just don't think they're – I mean, they have a good quarterback in Quinn Ewers, but he's had some terrible games this year. Michael Penix Jr. has had the most passing yards in the country this year. He's been one of the best quarterbacks in the country. He's very accurate. I'm definitely going to take Washington in this game. Being 5-point underdogs is a little crazy to me, but that's fine. But I'm going to take the under. I don't think it's going to go over 60. I mean, Washington has a very good offense, but I don't think Texas is going to score that much against them. And I think that Washington might win like 37 to like 27 or something. It's 37 to like 20 or just like a little lower. I just don't think, I don't know. I think like Washington has a good offense. Texas has a decent defense. So like Washington might get held to like 30 points instead of 40 points, which might be the difference in this one. But yeah, I don't think it's going to.
Yep, I agree with you on everything. I just think, you know, Washington, not because we're like Pac-12 biased or anything like that. It's just you look at the way Texas has played and you look at the way Sarkisian coaches the team, and overall it could be done a lot better, especially with the resources that they have. Whereas Washington, they don't have a lot to start off with, but they make the most of it. And in the Pac-12, they demonstrated that.
They're a 10-2 team, played an 8-4 team, and the conferences are relatively similar. The Pac-12 had a better year this year, but yeah. I mean, Washington had a tough loss to UCLA at the beginning of the year, where UCLA pretty much dominated them, and then they lost to Arizona State, which in a very close game. But they could easily be 11-1 right now. I mean, they didn't play some of the other good Pac. They didn't play Utah, and they didn't play USC, but they still won.
They played Oregon at Autzen Stadium,
and they beat Oregon at Autzen, which is a very tough thing to do. And they have some guts. So I like Washington.
All righty. So that's a good one. You know, maybe anyone watching, that's definitely one of the big ones. The next one is the Duke's Mayo Bowl. We have the 7-5 Maryland against 23-ranked 8-4 North Carolina State. Maryland actually enter this game as favorites, although North Carolina State are ranked. I'm guessing that might be due to injuries or something along those lines. It's supposed to be a very close game. The spread is at 1.5, and the over-under is 48 points. Just to keep it, you know, sweet and simple for me, haven't watched these teams play too crazy, but what I do know is that North Carolina State, again, is one of those teams that has been ranked the entire season, or at least a good majority of the season. Although they are an ACC team, they had those games against Clemson, against Wake Forest, and I remember those games being very close and almost winnable for them. Yeah. So to have them as underdogs, I feel like that puts a big chip on their shoulders. They're going to come into the game. They're going to come into the game strong, fierce, easily win. I feel like they can easily cover the spread, and I feel like they can easily score more than 30 points, and Maryland keep it a close game, maybe with team 10 points.
Yeah, I think that Maryland's going to win this game. I think they're going to cover, and I think it's going to go the under 47. I think that North Carolina has a very average, below average offense. They were ranked high early in the year because of their defense, but their offense is not good enough to complement them. And I just think Maryland had like close games with Ohio State, even Michigan. So I'm going to take Maryland in that game.
All right. Moving on to another big bowl game for, well, us at least, maybe not to a lot of people, but again, a big bowl game. I feel like it is a heavy mismatch. Just like I'm probably just as passionate about this game as I am about the Oregon North Carolina game. But we've got 8-4 Pitt, short for Pittsburgh, facing up against 9-3, 18th ranked UCLA in the Tony the Tiger Sun Bowl. Tony the Tiger has a bowl game, everybody. You know the guy on the Frosted Flakes box? He has a bowl game.
Yeah.
But yeah, UCLA, obvious favorites, -225 on the money line, expected to win by 6.5, over-under only at 57.5 points. What, you know, as a UCLA fan, who do you have winning this game?
I feel like we got to win this game and get this 10-win season after the season that we had. We were very close. If we beat USC in that very tight game in Arizona, we could have been in the Pac-12 championship and potentially the college football playoff. So it's a little bit disappointing, but we don't deserve to make it to the college football playoff with our abysmal defense. So
it's kind of
karma for that. But we have the best running game in the country by a pretty significant margin. Our offensive line is very good. We have one of the best running backs in the country. I don't know if he's going to play. I don't know if DTR and Charbonnet are going to play. But if they do play, assuming that everyone on UCLA plays, I see that UCLA is going to win this game relatively easily. Pittsburgh's offense, I don't think, can hang with us. I think that Pittsburgh's running game is very good, but I just think that the teams that really score a lot of points against us are the teams that have really mobile and dual threat quarterbacks that can run and pass. And I just don't think Pittsburgh's offense is that dynamic. So I'm going to say UCLA is going to win. They're going to cover the 6 points. And honestly, it's going to go the over because our defense is terrible and our offense is very good. So even if we score 40 points, I think that we'll give up like, at least, I mean, 20, 25, 30 points. But yeah. I think UCLA is going to win this game comfortably. Who knows, though, because we always give a lot of points, but hopefully we win comfortably. But I'm going to take the over. For sure the over because, yeah.
Yeah, I think, you know, like I said, I think it's just a heavy mismatch. UCLA easily wins the game. They easily win by more than a touchdown, and they easily cover the over-under. Again, like you said, UCLA are a team to go into a game and score 40 points, but then they are a team to let up 40 points. Yeah. So,
yeah.
It's gonna just go for – I would still go for UCLA winning the game. I don't think Pitt is that good. So, again, very big mismatch there. Another good game that is very actually worth watching is 8-4, 21st-ranked Notre Dame against 8-4, 19th-ranked South Carolina. Now, South Carolina have been making a little bit of a name for themselves with Spencer Rattler. And the last few games, they beat who were the two teams that they beat the last two games of the season?
They beat Tennessee and Clemson.
They beat Tennessee and Clemson, that's right. But South Carolina do come in the game as underdogs, plus 115 on the money line for South Carolina. They're expected to lose by no more than 3 points, and the over-under is at 51.5. What's your analysis of this game?
I think South Carolina had a very underrated year this year. They had a few just clunkers in the middle of the year that they should have won and they lost, but Spencer Rattler's a good QB. They absolutely dominated Tennessee, and that was when they had Hendon Hooker. I mean, he got hurt in that game, but they dominated Tennessee, and Tennessee was a very good team. They beat Clemson in a close game at Clemson, so they won in Death Valley. So I like South Carolina this game. Notre Dame has had a very average year. I mean, they beat Clemson, but they're a very mediocre team. Their offense is not dynamic at all. Their quarterback is transferring. I think South Carolina big, actually. I think South Carolina is going to win this one big. Mm-hmm. I think that – so they're going to cover, obviously, because they're underdogs. But I think South Carolina relatively big, like maybe 10 points even. And I think it's going to go – I think it's going to go over because the South Carolina offense has been pretty good.
Yeah, I agree. I think, what South Carolina have been doing recently has been really good for the program. I feel like they got off to a really bad start, but Spencer Rattler slowly started to, connect with his players a lot more, start to figure it out a lot more. And Notre Dame, again, the entire season has just been very rocky for them. Yeah. And, I look back to their game against USC and, they showed up in like the first quarter, but then after that, it's just, if you have a lead over Notre Dame, it's kind of like they're done for. So I feel like as long as South Carolina get out early, they'll be good to go. As long as for the spread, I don't think it'll be that close of a game. I think I think it'll definitely be more than a 2.5 point game. And then the over under, I definitely think both of these teams can score at least 30 points. So I would go over on the 51.5. Over under for that. The next one, again, one of these, bowl games where, we don't really hear too much about either of these teams, but they're literally evenly matched. It's the Barstool Sports Arizona Bowl between 9-4 Ohio and 7-5 Wyoming. The money line, both at minus 110. The spread is literally at zero, and the over under is at 43. Quick pick here. We can't really talk about this too much because we don't know about either team and it's so evenly matched. I'm just going to pick Wyoming because I know in the past they've done well. So Wyoming?
You're going to pick Wyoming. I'm going to pick Ohio just because of the record. I honestly have no idea, but
sure.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah.
There's nothing else we could do about it. It's just one of those games. The next one is going to be the Transperfect Music City Bowl against Iowa and Kentucky. Both teams are 7-5. Iowa are coming in as the favorites at minus 125. They aren't expected to win by more than 3 points. And the over-under is at a low 31.5 points. What do you think about that?
Iowa's offense is absolutely abysmal, but they have a decent defense and a very good punter because they really need a punter with that terrible offense. Kentucky, I don't think they're going to have their quarterback, Will Levis, in the bowl game. I think these teams are both pretty average. The over-under is at 31. It might even go under that. So I'm going to take the under, which is hard to say. I'm going to take Iowa to win and just Iowa. They're just kind of pests. So I'm going to take Iowa.
I feel like my big argument in this game is I look at two things. One, I look at that dreadful Iowa-Iowa State game that was like 10 points combined.
Oh, yeah, it's terrible.
And then I look at the fact that Kentucky was in the top 20 for a while.
They were, and then they just totally fell off, but they were in the top 25.
Yeah, I'm going to go Kentucky. I'm going to have them covering the spread. And 31.5 points does, look very low, but Iowa is the sort of team to only score a field goal, and that be that. So maybe go under for the 31.5 total. Maybe they've got something going there. Yeah. And then the last game for this episode, if you're watching on YouTube, is going to be the 22-ranked Mississippi State Bulldogs against Illinois. Both teams are 8-4. You think this is a even matchup, or do you think, you know, being an SEC team kind of makes the difference between a Big Ten team like Illinois? What have you got for me?
I think this is difficult because Mississippi State just lost their head coach, Mike Leach, and I feel like that's going to really hurt that program. And you don't know if it's going to help them in the sense that they're going to, like, try to use that as motivation to win the game, or they're going to just be distraught because of it. Illinois had a decent year this year. They had a pretty good defense. But they're in the Big Ten. I feel like Illinois is favored. I don't know how Mississippi State is going to respond to the Mike Leach tragedy. So I'm going to take Illinois in this game under 46 and Illinois to cover.
For that game, you know, it's very sad about what happened to Mike Leach. And as much as I would like, you know, Mississippi State to go into the game, win the game and be like, yeah, that was for coach. Like, you know, all this kind of, I just feel like, you know, realistically against Illinois, I just don't think it's going to pan out for them, unfortunately. So I'm going to go Illinois across the board. On YouTube, this is going to be the end of the second part. In the third part, we're going to go over the New Year's 6. I should say the New Year's 4 because we're going to be excluding two of the games, and those are the semifinal games. So, overall, we're going to be talking about the New Year's 6 games. It's a lot, you know, a lot more at stake, a lot better teams to talk about. So it'll, you know, we'll definitely talk about the games a lot more than just saying, okay, who's going to win this game and then moving on. But yeah, this is the end of part 2. Make sure to watch part 3. Follow us on our social medias. And yeah, that's going to be that.